Let us discuss user-defined primitives. User-defined primitives as we have built-in gates and switch primitives. Likewise, user-defined primitive, the name itself is suggesting, telling user-defined primitive. So we can describe any hardware that we are looking for or we are desiring for. So that can be described using this user-defined primitive feature in a Verilog HDR. There are two types of UDPs. One is a combinational UDP, the other is a sequential UDP. In a combinational UDP, elsewhere I will be referring it to CUDP and then sequential UDP, SUDP. So here in point number 3, you see how we instantiate UDP, the way we use it to instantiate our gate primitive or switch primitive. Like AND, space, and then instantiation name, and within parentheses first output, followed by that inputs. So like that we have to instantiate. Now let us go to next slide. UDP basics. Here UDPs are defined as an independent of modules, means within module and end module we are not going to write separately. We are going to write with the help of keyword primitive and end primitive. So I am emphasizing here this point, end primitive is a single word. It is not that there are two words, end is different and primitive, in between there is a space. No, end primitive. So say standalone, we are not going to write this one UDP within a module and end module. Separately we are going to write with the keyword primitive, and then we are going to wind up the description with a end primitive. So let us go to next slide. UDP, two forms are there. One form is port list declaration. The other form is port list type declaration. So this is 2005 language standardization and this is 1995 language standardization. So here the way we list out first port identifiers, maybe input and outputs, we list out here. But here if you look at, we even declared them apart from listing them. That is the difference in a form 1 and form 2. Here you remember this output underscore port is the only thing, and here input ports. So here from this we can conclude we have only one output. There could be several inputs. So now the way we use it to declare type, port type declaration with the help of keyword output and with the help of keyword input. Likewise, we even do the same declaration as port association in a primitive for user defined primitives as well. So here reg is the keyword used. This is only for applicable for only sequential UDPs. As I stated, we do have combinational UDPs and sequential UDPs. So output needs to be redeclared with the keyword reg. This is applicable for only sequential UDPs. So initial, if you want to assign this output underscore port or output port, so what is that we have to do is we assign you in a initial. So remember, no always here, only initial. Always and initial are procedural blocks. So initial is the only procedural block that is used in primitives. So after that we have to describe our hardware here, so our functionality here, that is done within a table and end table. So in subsequent slides you will see. So and then finally, once you have done with this description, then end primitive. Let us go to the next slide. In this next slide, points to remember, very very important, all these points are: first argument must be the output port and the other arguments are input ports. This is the point number 1. In a module you can have first inputs being declared and later on output. Primitive, user defined primitives, first it is compulsorily output port only, followed by that input ports. Either way can be done in module and end module. So second point is, a UDP can have exactly one output port but can have multiple input ports. So This is stated already. Point number three, the maximum number of inputs is limited by implementations, but must have at least 9 inputs for sequential UDP and 10 inputs for combinational UDP. So it can go even beyond this, but minimum must have at least 9 inputs for sequential UDP and 10 for combinational UDPs. Let us go to the next slide. Here all ports of UDPs are scalar. All ports, input ports and output ports, are scalar type, no vector type. They cannot be bidirectional in-out ports or vector ports. In-out is a keyword. If bidirectional port is there, then we have to declare with a in-out. So this is not there in primitive. The output can only have a single bit value with one of three states. Output can have only single bit value of obviously, because scalar, so only single bit. That value could be 0, 1 or x. The high impedance Z is not supported. The Z values passed to UDP inputs are treated as X values. If you are providing a Z high impedance state for testing purpose, then that will be treated as X. The behavior of a UDP is defined by a state table. So this is the behavior, what hardware that you are going to describe. So that is done with a state table. State table begins and is terminated with the following keywords: table, end table, as we have seen in previous slides. Each row of the table defines the output for a particular combination of the input values and is terminated by a semicolon. Each row is terminated by a semicolon, and a particular combination of input values will define the output. The permitted values for input ports and outputs are, as stated earlier, 0, 1 and X. High impedance is not allowed. The order of the input ports of each row must be exactly the same as they are in the port list. In port list, you have A, comma B. Here also, for A, related input needs to be declared, and for B, related input needs to be declared. Not that first for B you are declaring and later on for A. No. So now UDPs, let us summarize. UDPs, user defined primitives, model functionality only. They don't model timing or process technology. We cannot have timing delays like hash 2. So such delays are not allowed. Timings are not allowed. Process technology means we cannot associate to any implementation technology. They have exactly one output terminal and are implemented as a lookup table in memory. They have exactly one output terminal. So this is obviously already we have seen. UDPs are not appropriate method to design a block because they are usually not accepted by synthesis tools. Self-explanatory this one. So UDPs are not supported by synthesis tools, only for functionality checking. UDP state table should be specified as completely as possible, because we are defining how the hardware should behave, so we have to keep in mind all possible cases. It should use shorthand symbols to combine table entries wherever possible. So we'll see in next session shorthand symbols for UDPs. Okay, thank you.